morning, I wanted to make a video about making vegetable broth. So after you return from the farmer's market, normally you have a lot of scraps that you are going to compost. But I want to talk about how you make delicious veggie broth, which is, you could just keep it in jars in your fridge. It lasts about a week, 10 days, and you can use it for all kinds of cooking. In fact, I'm just using some now to make a quick 10-minute winter soup. Because your broth is already so rich with a veggie flavor as opposed to water, it's basically already a pre-made soup, and you just boil some vegetables. Let's talk about how you make the veggie broth to make it really good. Basically, when you have the let's say fennel, that's a great vegetable. So I save actually the fennel to use in the soup when I eat the actual soup, but the tops are a perfect green. So the tops of the fennel, I'll take a scissors and kind of chop it up so more of the flavor will come into the water. And I do the same with celery tops. So those are like the two favorite ingredients for a broth. When you have the chance to get leeks too, these are wonderful, wonderful. Any allium is great for soup. Alliums are so good for you. So basically I'll wash them and also kind of crush them to help the flavors come out of these leaves. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all these greens. I use a Instant Pot. I used to use a regular pot, but now I don't have to watch it so much. So I'll just throw all those greens in. So here's a cabbage. I'm going to wash these greens off the sides of the cabbage instead of throwing them out. Then a couple of other tips to add flavor in. So in addition to the allium, you may add a garlic. I happen to have these like funny black garlic, which are fermented, and they're so I'll just put a clove of that into the broth. I'll put in one bay leaf. Here's a secret. I'll use a salted lemon. If you can also, let's say you just happen to squeeze a lemon, you don't have to throw out the rind. You keep the rind and you put that, like say half lemon rind, into your hot pot. That adds a nice tartness. So these are actually special. I really like these are a local fermented, salted and fermented orange that's native to Georgia called a trifoliatum. And then another tip is jars of things that you buy that have liquid in them that normally you just pour out when you're done. Some of them can be very tasty in a veggie broth base. So the liquid that olives come in, for example, that is it's got your salt in it. And let's say you buy those capers, the liquid at the end, you know, don't throw it out. You can use those in your broth. And another pearl is I get these. You can throw in like two salted anchovies. I buy a big can of salted anchovies and I'll use these not only in the broth, but when I cook the soup again. So that's sort of like adding fish sauce to your soup. But anchovies, of course, have lots of omega-3s and it's very good for you. So you put that all together and you fill in your pot. I like to, you know, if I was doing it on the stove, I would do it for about 3 hours to suck all the flavor out of these scraps. In the hot pot, I'll do maybe 30 minutes on high pressure, sometimes even an hour. I just want to extract all the flavor and nutrients I can from the stuff. In the pot, getting ready to go, I forgot to mention that it's good to throw in a few peppercorns and a chili pepper. This is a poblano. And then when I'm done, I'll cool it and I'll strain the, I'll pour it over a bowl with a strainer on it and squeeze out all the liquid, and then I'll compost it. So then, you know, just put it in jars and keep it in your fridge. It'll last about 7 to 10 days. Here's another tip I forgot to mention, that if you don't have time or you don't have enough veggies at once to make your broth out of, what I do is during the week, as I cut scraps off, like kale stems, collard stems, I'll just throw them in a bag. Sometimes at the end of the the week when some of the veggies are gonna go bad and you can't eat it, just throw it in your freezer and use it to make a veggie broth. Never throw out raw vegetables. By the way, there's the walnut stash here. Yes, here's the steaming soup. It's very delicious. So all I did, again, was just put the top on the lid, boil it down. The vegetables then cooked 10 minutes. I put in a teaspoon of this dashi miso I bought at the Asian supermarket. And it's so delicious. That's just so easy to make. That's my secret to really delicious soups.